Hi, I'm Richard Handley, and my film is The Black String. I'm produced, co-write, and I star as Dr. Jason Rinaldi.
It's amazing to have you here with us at FrightFest. What does it mean for you to be part of this beautiful celebration of horror?
Oh, it's been an amazing ride. It's everything we expected and more. The scale of the film festival is extraordinary. We've become part of this gigantic family of ravenous fans who embrace this type of work. And so we're very lucky and very fortunate to be here. It's quite an honor.
What is the magic of horror? What does horror give storytellers and an audience they don't get from other types of cinema?
Oh, wow, that is a deep question. Visceral, okay, so it comes from a place that it could come from our worst fears, our greatest hopes, and the collision of those two, you know, greatest hopes versus worst possible outcome, that is something that strikes humanity at a very, very deep place. And our movie kind of rides the razor's edge of drama, indie drama, horror elements, psychological thriller elements, and it's a two-edged sword, or two sides of a coin. It's, you know, is he psychiatrically, hang on, is he suffering from mental illness, or is he cursed?
Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit about your character and where you fit in on screen in this project?
My character, Dr. Jason Rinaldi, yeah. So I had the fortune of helping to write this character into the script. And as a medical provider, as a physician, it was quite a challenge to both strike a realism and, you know, have fun with it and play with it. And we get the benefit of the entirety of the story being projected through Frankie's point of view, or Jonathan's point of view. And, you know, so he sees things from a skewed perspective. The medical, you know, institution in which he's projected into is not what you would see in reality, but it is. And so we were able to kind of play with both sides of that as well.
And I think, obviously, Frankie's an actor that people are very familiar with and maybe have expectations from. Can you talk a little bit about what they're going to get from this performance they perhaps haven't from his previous work?
Well, yeah, this is unlike anything Frankie Muniz has ever done. And it required a certain gravitas on his behalf. You know, he's known for being a comedic actor, television actor. He's done some theatrical work on the big screen as well. But now he's all grows up, right? And he got it. He read the script and he understood it innately. He's a very intelligent guy. And he's like, okay, I got this. Couple that with Brian Hansen's direction, and it was a culmination of both his intellect, his intuition, and then he was able to give the dramatic moments when necessary, and he was also able to, you know, let his comedic sensibilities come through as well. So it was a great balance. It's a masterwork performance in terms of Frankie's ability to kind of switch between the two. So it's quite surprising, I think, when you see this. You'll expect one thing based on what you've seen him do before, but it's surprising in his aplomb, his ability to, you know, bring forth something that's very unexpected. So I think you'll enjoy that.
And I think, obviously, the occult elements of this story are quite familiar tropes in kind of horror. Why do you think that you know, sort of Rosemary's Baby style of horror captures our imagination so much? Why does it seem to be such a universal language in horror?
Oh, great, great question. So, yeah, I think that these tropes and thematic elements seem to come together for most people that enjoy this because, again, like I said, it goes back to our deep, dark, you know, places in the recesses in our souls and our psyches and our thought process. Can I start that over? Yeah. It's a great question. Yeah, it resonates with people. You know, we tried to strike a balance between, you know, catering to a larger audience and the horror audience. It almost plays almost completely like an indie drama. But the horror and the psychological elements of it, we hope that it has an impact deep in people's, you know, souls, that they're like, they watch and they're like, oh man, that looks too familiar, it sounds too familiar, perhaps people have gone through or known people who've gone through these situations, and so it resonates because it deals with that type of realism, both from a medical standpoint and also from the occult standpoint too. There's a lot of people who are involved in that kind of thing. And so we did our research. Brian, in particular, did his research on what is that world, that universe, all about. This is one of the premier festivals in regards to, you know, starting the careers of many filmmakers. It's important to new filmmakers and people who want to become filmmakers. They're looking to this. Like we, for years, Brian and I have been looking to FrightFest as one of the places we would love to get into. And to be here actually premiering our movie and being a part of this is very surreal. So I would encourage filmmakers out there, if you're interested in making movies in the genre world, don't sell yourself short. Believe it can be done, and with enough time, effort, and focus, it can get done.